Hi guys, this is Shiraz and that's the Triumph Bobber. I've been riding it since Friday and today's Monday and I have to return the bike in a couple of hours. So I thought of giving you a quick walk around of this beautiful machine. And the full review will follow later on, okay, in a week or a fortnight's time. So yeah, let's go for it. I haven't yet started the motorcycle. Because the key is right here. And I was on the left hand side. Alright, so I'll start it for you. That's the ignition. Okay, so now I'll switch the ignition off. So that you can see the needle doing its magic. Yes, once again. Okay. Yeah, the low fuel light just came on. Let me show you. So I've just ridden the bike for 172 kilometers. I think I'll be able to complete 200 before I give the bike back in a couple of hours. That's not mine. Okay, so that's the average fuel efficiency. It shows 4.3 liters per 100 kilometer. I guess that's around the mark that Triumph claims for this motorcycle. Of course, I'll give you the exact fuel efficiency figure that I was able to manage in my short ride of 2.5-3 days in my comprehensive review, which would follow shortly. Okay, so that's the range. You have two bars right now and it shows 40, that the bike would run for around 42 kilometers before it runs dry. Okay, so that's the accurate time. Yeah, it's 6 o'clock in the morning right now. Of course, the bike is stationary, so that's 0 RPM. That's traction control on. Okay. I just did an acceleration run with the traction control switched off. Pretty happy with the result. I'll be sharing the speed, that acceleration run soon as well. Okay, so enough of me talking. Let me just make you hear the bike. Okay, so I'll have to press the clutch, so you'll have to excuse the camera angle for a second. Okay, let me see if I can manage like that. So it idles at around 1000 RPM. Sounds pretty sweet. Let me switch it off. Okay, and the seat is adjustable too. In fact, when it was given to me, okay, it can be pushed forward, which I've done right now. There's still some space, but that is the furthest it would go. And I don't know whether you can see that. So loosen the bolts, adjust the seat, tighten it up, put it back, and yep, So you have the perfect ergos for your height. Of course, not exactly the perfect, or I don't want to break the suspense right now. I would be talking about it in the detailed review. So yes, that's the long and short of it right now, including that long wheelbase. Okay. Alright, that was a bad one. Anyway, I hope you liked the video, and if you have any questions which you want me to cover in the review, just shoot them to me in the comment section below and I'll incorporate them in the review. And thank you so much.